on Forbes for the last whole week, and we just did some work, and I said we would have a flat spot going here. No flat spot there. Got a little bump to finish it off, though. Was the defending world champions coming into the week, and go out of here as the repeat defending champion. There, but other than that, a good run. The second run of the finals. Looks a little flat towards the end. He scored and went outside the mark. Definitely a different technique there. Had a great run going. Too bad, lad. Mark is 1267, fellow countrymen.
Yes, now it's done. We're at the last day of the Bermuda World Bacardi World Championship in Tornado class, and we have won the last race, and because of winning the last race and Leon Ballester coming fourth, we have the same points, and the rules say because we have 1 second and he doesn't have any second in the series, we are in front, and so we are very happy that we won this world championship. And the Bacardi Blast was taking place right after that, and it was good fun and good for the spectators to see. I think best conditions, strong winds, and a lot of people capsizing, and I think the Bacardi Blast was won by the Australians now, but we are very happy to take the trophy home again. Second time for us being world champion. Roland won it last year and I've won it in 93, and so second time world champion, and we are very happy with it.
Now moving into the open category, in fifth place, we have Darren Bundock and John Forbes from Australia. Hope they got a big suitcase for all this hardware. And in fourth place, Johannes Polgar and Christian Happel from Germany. And in third place, from down under, Mitch Booth and Andrew Bischel. I'm sorry, it's Adam Bischel. And in second place, the gold medalists in Atlanta last year, Fernando Leon and Jose Ballester from Spain. And some of you may not realize that we actually had a tie for the scoring was even for first and second, and it was broken on a double tiebreaker. But for the second year, the winner, Roland Gaebler and Rene Schwall from Germany.
heute hatten wir nochmal einen sehr anstrengenden Tag. Das war der vorletzte Tag dieser Weltmeisterschaft. Und es hat hier mit 25 bis 30 Knoten Wind geblasen heute. Und die vorderen Plätze waren sehr hart umkämpft. Die ganzen Favoriten haben sich eigentlich in beiden heutigen Wettfahrten die ersten 5 Plätze geteilt. Und wir sind noch gespannt auf die Gesamtliste. Heute wird der Streicher mit eingerechnet. Und wir gehen davon aus, dass wir jetzt in zweiter Position liegen mit einer gewissen Chance noch auf den Titel. Müssten vielleicht so 6 bis 7 Punkte Rückstand auf den vorderen haben. Und sind gespannt auf den morgigen Tag. Wenn er auch nochmal Wind bringt, haben wir noch eine gewisse Titelchance und versuchen die zu nutzen.
We've just had heat 6 and 7 and tomorrow's the last day. We've got one heat tomorrow. We've had about 18 to 20 knots today and I think heat 7 was in about 25 knots. Tomorrow we're expecting the same again, probably 20 to 25 knots. So that's good for us because we like it when it blows. We had a 4th and a 5th today and if we can do the same tomorrow we'll be in the top few. If we didn't have the light race in heat 3 we'd be 2nd overall, so let's pray for a bit more wind.
Thank you.